Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about work management or Jira work management, which we are using for our day-to-day life. When we are talking about work management, let's understand by using one example. Let's say HR team wants to onboard any particular employee. So definitely they will need the signed offer letter, employee documents, IT provisionings, review, and finally, the candidate will be onboarded. So if you can see here, these are the templates which is already created. But for one candidates, remembering each and everything is possible. But let's say we have hundreds of candidates to be onboarded. So it's always required to be tracked in any applications. So generally, this type of activity is tracked within an applications to monitor each and every phases. And anyone who wants to view the status of any employee, they will be able to see it from here. So we'll show you how we can build this complete step from scratch. So please be available from start to end of this video. And if you want to learn about complete Jira, please watch my Jira playlist. I will include the URL in description tab so that will be easy for you to understand. Now, here for creating the work management process to the board, so let me show you id.atlassian.com, and from here I am selecting work management. If you want to create a new project, simply click on create a project and select work management, where you will see project management, task tracking, new employee onboarding. These are the templates which is created by Atlassian team. As of now, I've already created this template. Simply you have to select this template, add the name and click on create. This board will be created for you. I exactly selected the onboarding process template where I found this board is available. So this board is first is sign offer letter. So let me add the task for any employee. So let's say I am adding a task for employee Rai. Now this is done. Let me add employee Gurukul. This is also done. Next is employee Rai Gurukul. So let's say we are working on three tasks. Let's say employee Ra is working on any specific activity or he is going to support inside the IT team. So let's say I want to add just IT label here. It means this will be tagged with the IT employee. And if anyone who is from IT management side, probably they want to check the status of employee Ra. So they will go to this page and see it. Let's say employee Rai has already submitted signed offer letter. Now, so HR team or anyone or the HR team will move this tile into the employee documentations. It means this Rai has to submit all the documentations. Now, let's say Gurukul has already done sign offer employee documents and he is sitting on IT provisioning. So it means whoever is the team of Gurukul, they will be able to see easily. So how we can see the process? And whenever we want to have a look about anything, we can move one by one so that the person or the associated team member can see the status of their existing employee or onboarding employee. Now, if I want to customize this cards, probably I will add some other fields. So here, this is a card where we can see category, region, hire, date of hire. So probably we'll add date of hire, department and hiring manager. So here we can customize this. We can see summary, status, key, type, assignee, due date, subtask, priority, label, category, date of hire, departments, hiring manager, job role, now locations and start date. So we can see everything here. Now you can see which are options I've selected. It's available here. Now if I want to tag as an IT member, so IT support, maybe I will add this role. So IT support is a role. Now department is IT, date of hire, let me select a second, location maybe London, UK. There is a typo. Now start date for this person is second because getting hired. Category I am selecting. If you have any category, we can add it. Now even if want to tag the hiring managers, we can also specify the hiring manager name, so everything will be included. And even if this candidates to be hired quickly or this is a critical requirement from the management team, then probably we can add as a highest. So this is how we can add any cards on formations within the board. Now let's see, I want to perform some project settings or maybe adding some additional filters which we can add it. So for those reasons, we have to navigate it to the workflow, and from the workflow we can customize the board according to our need. Now we can see this person detail is quickly available, and here we have list. So if we can see in the list format, probably we'll have all this detail in the list. And even if it is assigned to any particular person, so we can see the assigned person name, comments, if you have any comments, due date, when does that person to be there. So we can, maybe you can add like this. And the reporter, even if you have any labels, we can also attach these labels. If you have any labels, we can attach these labels here. In the calendar format, we can also see the calendar of candidates. So here we can have the due date for this added list. Now at any point of time, if I want to rename this process, so probably I will change the name and update the field so that this name will be updated. Now here, again, same thing we can do it. Let's do it as an employee document, and we have this employee document name is available. And even we can merge this, collapse this, and if we have multiple fields which is required to be scrolled up and down, so probably we can add this things available. Now we can collapse this something like that. So if we have multiple fields, we can see it in this format, which is very interactive format of looking work or any particular status of the employee or the onboarded employee. Now at any point of time, I want to add few other details, like maybe I will add infosec clearance is one step, and apart of that, I'm also expecting to add one more field, that is background verifications or maybe BGC. So here we will add this. So BGC, maybe I will add here, and after that infosec validations, and then we have this many fields. Now we can see these all are stages. If I want to expand it, so simply I will click on this, and then if I want to move it to any other stage, I will probably do it. So one employee is lying inside the employee documentation, other one is lying in IT provisioning, then one is lying in the BGC report. If we have to share with any of the team members or with the reporting manager or hiring managers, probably will include here the name of the person, add the message, and click on share. At any point of time, if I want to apply the filter, let's say I want to apply due this week, so whoever candidate is due for this week, we can see the result. So here this one candidate is due for this week, rest are already onboarded. So this is applications of, even we can add more filters like assignee, category, type, label, so priority, status. So these all filters are available, which is helping user to have a look about their work. So I'm expanding all the column. Even we can show by group by, that is priority wise, assignee wise, category wise. we can see the result. Now, in the report sections, we can see the reports as well. That I will cover in further part of video. So the intention is to showcase how the work management will look, and even we can see there are summary here. Anything which isn't not done. So we can see the status here. Three stages are done, three are created, one is due for next 7 days. And here we can see the status chart where status overview is showing all. Recently activity we can see in the summary board, types of work, which all types of work we can target. Priority background, we can see highest, high, medium, which is very interesting feature of Jira Work Management, where we have everything available into our board. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.